Hello, beautiful person. I just wanted to spend a couple of minutes with you talking about patience because, it's hard to be patient right now when so many of us are being asked to stay home, to resist our absolutely human desire to socialize with other humans. And also, we're thinking, how long is this going to carry on? So, I saw a tweet today from or a piece today on CBC, which was I saw on Twitter, about talking about how some experts are saying 2 or 3 months. That's kind of impossible for me to get my head around, and I'm sure the same is true for you. And I'm just talking about Manitoba because I don't really know about other places, but I know for us, we've been home for a few days now. I don't even know. Remember when it started, but I haven't been keeping track of the days. Maybe I should have, but I mean, we're not under absolute lockdown, but I mean, we're very strongly requested, shall we say, and the province does have has given itself emergency powers if people are really flouting the social distancing. And I've been seeing pictures about plexiglass shields in grocery stores, which I think are a great idea, and so on. But we're in this thing and we're wondering how long is it going to last. And the problem is nobody can really tell us. My daughter is in grade 12 this year. We were supposed to start with we've been fundraising, we've been supposed to measure her dress for alterations this week, all these things, and grad coming up, and it's all just up in the air. If it's a month, then maybe we can still have grad. Who knows what's happening with their they are doing distance learning, but if not, who knows? And we've got Passover coming, we've got so many things, and many people have Easter, and it's like we are in an unprecedented time. And that's why I wanted to talk about patience, because patience is a virtue. Patience is something that we really need to be working on. And so I really wanted to wish you peace and patience. And yesterday, when I was talking about stress, I did mention Gabby Bernstein as a great resource for meditations, and she's actually offering a free workshop for reducing anxiety. And thinking impatience very often comes from anxiety, and vice versa, they feed off each other. And both of them are really bad to have right now. I mean, obviously, we're all anxious because we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know whether we can keep our loved ones safe. Many of us don't know where our next paycheck is coming from. So there's a lot of things to make us anxious. And that's why, hi, Tara. And that is why it's so important to breathe, to indulge in self-care, take care of yourself. And that reminds me. And next Wednesday, I'm doing a Zoom about self-care. So if you want to know about that, you can drop me a message and I'll send you information. Oh, thank you, Tara. I'm glad. So, I don't want to make this too long because we're also impatient. And but just wanted to remind you, I love you. You are loved. There are people out there who love and care about you, even if you can't see them. Pick up the phone, get on a Zoom. I just set up a Zoom for my family, which is scattered all over the globe. And I'm like, all these years we've had Zoom, why has it never even occurred to me to offer it to my family when I've been using it for work for 2 years? So there you go. There are good things to be coming out. I'm very excited to be seeing everyone on Zoom since I can't see them in person. And like I said, if you want to know about this wellness Zoom that I'm doing next week, drop me a message. Have a great day. Remember, I love you. Talk to you again soon. Bye.